way across the plains.
Pretty good one.
I might need a root beer. Oh.
Good evening from Fort Hartsuff. We are joined tonight by Jim Domar and Mary Hughes, and you guys have got some festivities going on out here tonight, don't you?
We do. We're going to have a night cannon firing tonight. We've had the reenactment group out here all day, and now tonight at about 9:30, we're going to fire off the cannon at night and try to put on a show.
Has your summer been pretty busy this
It's been about average. Yeah, can't complain about it. It's been pretty good.
People from all around Nebraska,
yeah. We've had
out of state.
We have 31 states so far.
31 states?
Three foreign countries.
Yeah.
So the traffic has been
good.
Good. Good. So good to see people coming through, and great. Well, we'll have you tell a little bit more about tonight. When does everything get started?
Well, it's been going on all day, and the firing's going to be at 9:30, so we're expecting people to start rolling in here probably 8:30 or so.
So they need a park permit to come out tonight?
They need a park entry permit is all they need.
Okay. Yep. And then they can go and tour the buildings? And,
well, the buildings will probably be, it's going to be dark. They'll probably be closed.
But if they would come out now,
they could still go out and tour the buildings.
Tour the buildings,
yes.
If they've never been here, go ahead and get out here. They could buy a permit if when they get here.
Yeah, they can buy their permits here.
So who do we have over here on the to our left?
Well, we've got Mike Schmidt and his son Alex. Mike's actually made the Gatling gun you see over here, and also the cannon that's behind me he made.
Have you guys been doing this for a long time?
I've been doing this for over 25 years.
Okay. And?
I've been doing this since I was pretty much born. He's been taking me along with him on most of them.
And do you enjoy it?
Oh yeah, it's a lot of fun. It's great to come out here and spend some family time with him and get to see all my friends and do this kind of stuff.
So, because you're from the eastern part of the state, eastern part of Nebraska?
Yeah, we're from the Fremont, Wahoo area.
So this is a nice trip out here to enjoy Fort Hartsuff for a weekend?
Yeah, Fort Hartsuff has always been one of my favorite places.
Wonderful. Yes, it is one of our destinations in and around the state. So we are really proud of it here too. What building do we have back behind us, Jim?
Right directly behind me is the the officers' quarters. Two lieutenants were stationed there with their family if they had any. Plus they had cooks and servants to do the work for them, and they stayed in that house too. Mm-hmm. And the post surgeon lived in that house too.
Mm-hmm. And then this building here that's right behind the guys?
That's the enlisted men's barracks. That was a soldier's home. That's where they stayed. It housed, anywhere to 60 soldiers probably. That was a full company at that time.
Okay, and then this is where everybody comes in then to the...
Yep, that's the post headquarters building. That was kind of the office building. The officers had their offices in there, and that's where the orders were written up, and that's where the mail came to. And it's our visitor center now, per se, and our gift shop.
Okay, and which direction would we like to go now? Would we want to go around to this side or the building over to right behind you now?
Directly behind me is the commanding officer's quarters. The commanding officer out here at Fort Hartsuff was a captain, and that's where he was, that was his living quarters.
Okay. Okay, and then around over, just make a little tour of the one right behind Mary.
Over
is
here. That, don't turn your back. That's the post hospital.
Okay, all right, and then we'll just go back around this way, and we'll look at the, out here to the vehicles. We might have you guys just come on around.
Okay.
What's the building out there then to the...
Okay, over here is the guardhouse. That's where the soldiers, if they did something wrong, were stationed. We have what were called the dark cells in there. They were kind of just wooden boxes, and they were put in there when they got caught for drunkenness or gambling and okay. acts like that.
Okay, and then the other two buildings?
Okay, the building up in this corner here is the laundress quarters and the bakery. There's 5 two-room apartments in that building, and the commissary sergeant lived in the apartment to the right, and that's he lived there because he was in charge of the wagon scale that's set behind that building, and also the quartermaster storehouse, the next building here. And then the middle three apartments were where the laundresses were housed, and the apartment clear to the left is the bakery, where the baker had his quarters. We had our oven, our wood-fired bake oven in there, and he made bread for the soldiers.
Wonderful. Well, if everybody can get back out here tonight, we'll come around and look at all the group that's gonna be here entertaining tonight, and they can come out and talk with all of them, can't they?
They can, yeah. They encourage you to come out and visit with them, and they're all historians. If you got questions, you can ask them and talk to them and visit them. We've got one soldier's got a display set up in the barracks of his military items, and you can come out and look at that.
Okay, so this is Gatlin's first model. This is an 1860s model Gatlin gun. He actually had usable guns by 1862. He had 6 guns that were actually destroyed in the Cincinnati foundry fire. And then after that, Colt took over the manufacture of them shortly after. And then that's just a little bit of history. So this is actually a 58 caliber. It's called a paper cartridge model. And it would have been, it was meant to use the same paper cartridges as the infantry soldiers in the Civil War. So they would load them into these little metallic cylinders, and then they'd be dropped into the hopper. Go ahead.
Absolutely.
Never gets old. So this here is a model 1864 Parrott rifle. Like a lot of times guns like that wouldn't have been out of the forts, but strangely enough, they had a bunch of surplus stuff from the Civil War, so a lot of these big guns like this got pushed out west and then abandoned. So even though it probably wasn't stationed here at the fort, there were a lot of guns like this that were actually brought out to these Indian Wars forts and then basically left. They were buried or abandoned or whatever. So this is kind of a representation of something that could have been out here or whatever. And it's a great crowd pleaser, you know. It's everybody likes to see the big boom go off and have a good time, you know. And so that's what we do. But I'd like to say, you know, without people coming out here, this stuff really doesn't have a purpose. So it's so important that people come out here and see this, because without it, this stuff becomes kind of meaningless, you know, if we can't do it for other people. And one of the things I've gotten out of this is the opportunity to share it with others. And that's one of the things that keeps me going.
Wonderful. That's great. And we know that Jim and Mary and everyone around here that are good hostess and host and accommodate you guys and enjoy it here. So, Jim and Mary, have anything more that you want to add tonight?
Well, we just want to say that we really appreciate these groups coming out and doing this, because this is what draws people in. This is what they want to come and see. They do like to come and look at the fort and things, but when you can make it come alive, it adds so much to it. and we just thank these guys for coming out and be willing to do that for us.
We do have one laundress that is here, and she's got she wrote a grant, so she's got root beer that's free. She's got salted peanuts in bags. She has handkerchief dolls that everybody can make, and she has, you can help make laundry soap. Well, so she did that all with grant money. So all of those activities are free for anybody who wants to do it.
And is everybody around here tomorrow too?
Yes. Everybody is still here.
About what time everybody come out tomorrow?
First thing in the morning, it'll start up again. They usually raise the flag at about 9 o'clock.
And they're doing church service, right, at 10?
We'll fire when we raise the flag.
Right.
They'll fire. I think they're doing a church service. Is that right?
No church service.
No church service tomorrow.
But the skirmish at 11.
Yep.
And then another skirmish at 1. And then usually by 3:30 or so, the guys start packing up and heading home.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Because they got a long trip back.
It's been a long day. Yes. But yes, thanks. It's been a great day so far. So hopefully tomorrow will be equally good.
Well, thanks for giving a tour of the grounds while mm-hmm. we were alive tonight. And thank you for contributing to the coverage. And we'll hopefully see you guys up here again. Come out and visit Fort Hartsuff. And
yeah, they usually try to come twice a year. They usually come in the spring and then again around August sometime.
Okay.
But there's still time to come out and watch the fire, cannon fire tonight. So try to get out here if you got time.
All right.
We had a gentleman that helps us with stuff, and he went around and got donations for gunpowder. So he got like $350 for donations in gunpowder.
Yes.
So we're hoping we have a really great show tonight.
Yeah. We want to thank him.
Yes.
Yeah. Without him, it'd be tough to put this on. So.
Well, thank you guys. All right, everybody, get out here tonight to Fort Hartsuff. We appreciate everybody contributing to the conversation while we were live. And come on out and enjoy the activities, and come on back tomorrow, too.
Okay.